If you are in need of Ultimate Team coins, check out IGXE.com in the description below, and if you use the code TREY at checkout, you'll get yourself 5% off. What is up, guys? TBRLTA here, and welcome to a brand new squad builder on my channel. This team's going to be built around the informed Damari Gray that you can see in that left forward position. But before we get into the squad itself, if you missed yesterday's squad builder, it was built around the American version of Gideon Zalalem. Obviously, when that comes into play in Ultimate Team, for the time being, he's still German, but hopefully he gets that American version card sometime soon and gets that change sometime soon, because that would be great to see, and obviously would make that team, if you didn't watch it, much, much better if he had an American version. It would allow him to get full cam. But anyway, for the time being, we're going to do this squad. It is built around the informed Damari Gray, like I just mentioned, and it is a very solid team. He was the only bronze informed card that I saw that I was like, yeah, I really want to use him. So I decided to build a squad around him. I was really unsure who else I wanted to put in this team, though, because if you guys have followed my channel for a while, you know I like to build hybrids. I don't really like the one nation squad. I don't like the squads where it's just one league. I really like to make my squads unique, and I was confused as to who else I was going to put in this team to make it a hybrid, and that's when Zan or DBGaming97 came into play and helped me out with this team. I suggest you guys go and subscribe to his channel. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. He makes some very top quality content and really helped me out with this team. If it wasn't for him, I would not have used Himuma, and honestly it would have been a big mistake if I haven't used Himuma. And you saw that goal he just scored, the free kick and the one where he banged it in the top left corner. He is an absolute stud in that right forward position. 14,000 coins is a bargain for him. Obviously, his one downside, in my opinion, for a winger, you probably should have 4-star skills, which he unfortunately does not. So that is his one downside. Damari Gray as well also doesn't have 4-star skills. If he had that, he would be perfect as well, but sadly, he does not have 4-star skills, but he is a G. Look at this. For a volley, first time, Damari Gray bangs it in, and this team is fantastic. But I gotta warn you guys, if you are a skiller, or at least like to enjoy using 4-star skill moves, unfortunately, this team does not consist of any 4-star skillers whatsoever, and, you know, that can be a bit unfortunate. I like to use skills from time to time, but for this team, it actually worked out very well with only having 3-star skillers or 2-star skillers, because it made you work and play a more patient game rather than trying to do something that's fancy and get past your opponents. So, without any further ado, let's move on to the goalkeeper. You can see Claudio Bravo right here. He played the majority of my games in net for this team, but sadly, he was a bit of a letdown. And I believe that says 12 games. I can't really see it on my computer screen right now, but he was a huge letdown. He let in basically every single long shot that flew at him, basically every single near post shot that went at him. He did not save anything. So I decided to give Iker Casillas a go, and he was 10 times better. 10 times the price as well, but 10 times better. I recorded this about a month ago, in case you were wondering about the prices. You can see when they're bought and whatnot. Recorded this about a month ago, and yeah, prices change and whatnot. I recorded a live commentary as well, but obviously things change in around a month, so I decided to do a post commentary on it right now that you guys are hearing right now. So if I sound a bit weird, that's because I'm not used to doing post commentaries. I usually do all my content live. But anyway, you can obviously see the second center back in this team is Diego Godin. Gets a link with our other center back that you saw in the thumbnail and at the beginning of this video, Jose Jimenez, gets an ultimate chemistry link. That is fantastic to see, because that obviously means we can hybridize this team in other positions, and Godin is definitely one of my favorite center backs in this game. Very underrated. I don't see him in many squads, and that's due to his low pace, but he wins every single header that comes at him, and he's very, very strong. Obviously, like I mentioned, I built this team around a month ago, and that was before he got his second inform. So you could use that card if you so wish, but I used his first inform, only 80,000 coins. I'm sure he's going for less than that now. He is amazing as a center back, especially partnered with Jimenez. They don't have the highest pace, around 69, I believe both of them are at, but still, they are very strong and have a great, great physical attributes other than their strength as well. So anyway, our left back, you can see, is Scott Goldborn. He is born to score goals, ha ha ha. But I wasn't planning on using him there. I was actually planning on using Joe Bennett, but after further review, Goldborn is 10 times better. Our right back is going to be another bronze card. It's going to be Mehdi Zafon from my favorite club, Olympic Lyon. Very, very, very solid. It actually surprised me. It says only only 80 pace, but my opinion, that is a lie. When the shorter they are, the faster they seem to be, and he honestly has around like 90 pace in game. It really feels like that, and he is one of my favorite right backs I've actually used this year. He is very, very good, surprisingly. But moving on to the next player in this team, it's going to be Jake Forster-Kaski. I really wanted to build a team with him in it as well. He was kind of in the criteria for what needed to be in this team, because I really do like Jake Forster-Kaski. If you follow my AFC Wimbledon career mode, you would know that as well. Very solid, obviously gets the links with Damari Gray and Scott Goldborn, so we can obviously hybridize this even more because he can now get two dead links such as Jimenez and Godin as well. So moving over to our next player in this team, whenever I decide to do it, there we go, is going to be a French center mid. It's going to be Jordan Veretout. Now you could go with several different French center mids in the league, but he is one of my favorite ones in this game and in real life, so I decided to put him into the team. Very, very solid, really well-rounded, great long shots as well, and I suggest you guys give him a go. I was tempted to use Jordan Ferry, of course, from Lyon in this team as well, but he's basically only better than Veretout in his pace, but other than that, Veretout is better than him in every other attribute. So Veretout, I really, really suggest you guys giving him a go. People really just don't tend to use him just because of the fact that he's a non-rare silver card, but he's very good, so I suggest you guys give him a go, as I was saying. But moving on to the next player in this team, actually going to be a CDM. It's going to be, I did not mean to do that, I don't know why I did that in my recording, it's going to be Blaise Matuidi. Now you could obviously get his inform card if you have the coins. I didn't have the coins at the time, so I decided to just go with his regular card. Still very solid. My only gripe with him is in this formation, it seems like he tends to drift forward a bit too much, even though I have him set to stay back while attacking in that in the instruction screen. He still seems to get forward way too much, and that kind of can be a bit frustrating at times, but he is the perfect center mid. Obviously, if you've used him before, you'd know how good he is at that center mid position. Very, very, very solid. Now, moving over to the striker position, you could have any English center mid in the championship, or you could also, actually it has to be someone in the championship at all, to get that link with Damari Gray, because he obviously can't have two dead links. So I was suggested by Dan to use Cameron Jerome. He put him in the squad he made for me to use, but I'd like to use players that I like in real life, and I don't really like Cameron Jerome that much, so I decided to use Nathan Delfonso. I don't really like him too much either, but 90 pace, you can't really go wrong. Obviously, you can see he does have low work rates, which isn't the greatest, of course, but I kind of thought it helped him a lot in the games I played with this team. He scored a lot of goals, and that was because he kind of just stood there, and when I needed to pass to someone, and you know, when there was no one else to pass to, he was always there because he was too lazy to move anywhere else. So it was pretty great at times to just pass to him, and then he'd use his pace to get through on goal and score, obviously, which is fantastic. That's exactly what you want in your striker, and he is perfect. Very, very cheap as well, and I'd really recommend him in that striker position. But anyway, that is the team as you can see on your screen in its glory. Very, very solid for what it costs. I believe it costs around 250,000, somewhere around that range. Very, very good. Suggest you guys give it a try. If you do give it a try, let me know in the comment section down below. But as always, I'll have clips after I'm done talking. I've been T-Ray all day. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm out. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.